Welcome to week two, day six of 30 days of painting ladies from the 80s. We're showcasing that of Jerry Hall, model and actress and goddess of the disco scene in the 1970s. My eyes hurt, but I kind of like it is generally the response I get when folks look at my paintings. The main objective behind the work is not necessarily celebrity, but using otherwise familiar personas to explore otherness. In other words, I'm trying to create a kind of mutation of the spectacle of youth and beauty. In light of June being Pride Month, I think I'd be remiss if I didn't explain the intention behind corrupting an image, and then the seeming redundancy of painting it. I'm interested in taking starlets and pipe icons of my upbringing and slicing them up as a kind of reassembly. A reassembly that forms a new body, one that is simultaneously multi-able, like an octopus or a spider, and monstrous, much like a contemporary vision of a superhero. I'm creating women that I both wanted to be and wanted to be with as I questioned my identity growing up, hence the focus on the 70s and 80s icons. By making them hideous, I'm reconsidering what much of the world looks at as abhorrent or disgusting, queer people, while alternately giving them capabilities that render them superhuman, a metaphoric representation of bravery. Why do I paint them? Because a long tradition of portraiture is about deeply looking. It's a meditative reflection of the character of a being through investigating their likeness, navigating the sublayers to get to an essence that honors a sitter's personhood in order to land on a common connection through our shared humanity. And by design, creating something that has flaws, presence, evidence of my hand, and copious amounts of time in the millimeters of layered paint showcases a kind of magical beauty in the surface. I hope you join me tomorrow as we jump in to day 7.